Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 9.1, Problem 2. This is Section 9.1, Problem Number 2. It says, find the sample mean and margin of error for each of the following confidence intervals. And the first one goes from 24 to 30. So a lot of times, if you can visualize this almost on a number line, it helps. So from 24 to 30, there's a halfway point of your confidence interval where the mean would be the sample mean. So to go from 24 to 30, that's a distance of 6 if you think of it on a number line. So 6, you would split half and half. It takes 3 to go to that midway point from the small end and from the big end. So that would be 27 is the middle. So 27 minus 3 gives you your 24. 27 plus 3 gives you your 30. So for part A, the sample mean equals 27, and the margin of error would be 3. So now for part B, it's a similar process. From 38 to 50, that's your confidence interval. So what's the sample mean and the margin of error? So again, picture that 38 to 50 on a number line. So to go from 38 to 50, there's a distance altogether of 12 to go from 38 to 50. So the halfway point occurs 6 bigger than the low end and 6 less than the upper end. So 38 plus 6 more would put 44 in the middle. 44 plus 6 more would bring you up to 50. So 44 is the midpoint. That must have been the sample mean of the confidence interval. And that distance from end to end from the midpoint of 6 will be your margin of error. So sample mean was 44, margin of error 6. So part C, the confidence interval goes from 180 to 210. What's the sample mean and what's the margin of error? So same process. Imagine 180 and 210 on a number line. So to go from 180 to 210, the midpoint where they meet, that would be your margin of error. So to go from 180 to 210 is a distance of 30. So to go halfway, if the whole distance is 30, halfway would be 15. So 180 plus 15 is 195. And just to confirm, 195 plus 15 more is 210. So the midway point, 195, would have to be a sample mean for this confidence interval. So sample mean, 195. Margin of error, 15. And finally, the last one, the confidence interval goes from 8.5 to 8.9. So here you do have some decimals, but it's the same process. Just picture 8.5 and 8.9 on a number line. So to go from end to end, from the 8.5 to the 8.9, the distance is 0.4. 8.5 plus 0.4 is 8.9. So halfway would be 0.2. So 8.5 plus 0.2 would put your midpoint at 8.7. And you can just confirm 8.7 plus another 0.2 is 8.9. So the midpoint or sample mean would have been 8.7. And the margin of error would be 0.2.